with the Nishoki flag. That's its official title, but it's more commonly known as the Kinomaru in Japan, as Goto Yui leads her players into the arena. Captain Kati Kolsa, 33-year-old, the best defender in the team. The players say she has a big Estonian heart. Goto Yui, the number three, absolutely outstanding. Number 10, Motoki, just 18 years old, but really growing in confidence and skills in this championship in line two there. And Shimoyama in the number three line, also putting in a good stint here in Singapore. Well, for Estonia, it's good to see Reti Vaart in there. She picked up an injury in the last match. It looked like a little bit of potential sprain, but she's shaking that off to make the start. Number 17. And we are underway. So, Estonia with a point to prove. They've been finding some goals in this competition. But Japan have two wins under their belt and have been growing in confidence as the competition's gone along with their debut players. Mad energy at the beginning of a match where everyone's just trying to find their place and how they're going to actually fit into the schedule. Oh, you have something, we're just going to work our way in. And that's the first proper shot. So Japan trying to get some possession here, and there we go, Motoki, she's quick, she's clever, and she's gone across the front of the goal. Nelly Alanko, very, very aware there that was an opportunity, but no goal. No, either side, Estonia nil, Japan nil. The beginning of the first 20 minutes of the match. And that goes backwards to Japan. Morinaga. Straight down to Yui Goto, and just overrun by Abiyu. Just trying to see if there's a decent route on goal. And that is the one she wanted. She found it absolutely spectacularly going across. Kati Kutisa.
She sees the spot, she takes just the right amount of steps and she places it. And the Estonian team are very, very, very happy here.
Happy you just around the back there. Oh, and that was a fantastically worked goal by Japan. The captain putting it out to the right, tapped in by the number six, and the goal absolutely delightedly being celebrated by Shimizu Mahiro.
On the power play, quick movement of the ball into the middle, to the side, and right back into the middle, and with the first touch into the net. No hesitation right there, just she knew exactly what she was supposed to do. They will start playing a little bit more of their own game. There's a little bit more.
Oh, and there we go. You said it, and as you said it, the goal went in. An absolute peach of a...
And there was such patience. She was about to turn the other way, realized, oh, there's no space here, turns back, and just with a lot of confidence, shoots that shot.
You coming out the corner beautifully there, and that was absolutely textbook once again. Morinaga Shinu just standing there waiting for the pass to come from Abiyu and tapping it in to level the match once again. Estonia 2, Japan 2.
Absolutely. We can see her having a little fight there in the corner, and just a beautiful backhand shot. I don't think
it's a pass, but actually, no. It's all her.
No one was expecting that.
Oh, Morinaga.
Yes, and The Japanese have have gotten back to their very, very, very tight.
Hirasawa not able to reclaim the ball there, so she retreats into defence as Estonia push in the final few seconds of this period. But it will stay at 2-2. Estonia 2, Japan 2. 20 minutes to go in this final match. It's been an enthralling second period. 4 goals scored in 20 minutes. It's all to play for when we come back in 10 minutes' time. Yes, it's important. You were telling me at halftime why you think that Japan are focusing so much on their defense.
Yes, it's because even with a tie, Japan will win the group. Because right now they're sitting at 4 points. They will gain 1 point for a tie.
What can Estonia produce? Oh, they can produce that! Thank you, says Pirit Kuidak. Taking the credit and the applause of her team. Yoko Natsumi returning from the sin bin.
And we can see just some wonderful work, individual work.
Abiyu. Marinaga again pushing the ball right up into that top corner. She's going to have a little go herself. And she's going to pop it in the net. A speculative shot by the number 21. Morinaga Shihu. Team kit.
An absolutely beautiful pass, and there she puts it in. They do, the Japanese, they have a very good aim when you look at it. It goes right next to the arm of the goalie. Orzmak had no chances of getting that, just between the floor and the arm.
Oh, and that was
an amazing save from Yamanaka in the Japanese goal. And we have Estonia 6-5.
Japan pushing forward, trying to get the goalkeeper on. And again, she is there, but she puts it into her own net. The ball wasn't going in, and so much was she trying to get into position. She carried the ball with her. An absolute despair for Saskia Ormac. Now we'll see what our referees decide. They're having a conflab, but Japan waiting to see if the goal's going to be given.
It looks
Saskia
like
Saskia Ormac, she's just distraught. Let's have a closer look at this. So, and it came off Sillig, and it was carried forward and under the legs.
It's a penalty shot for Team Japan. Because before the ball was in the goal, the referee had already put up her hand and whistled, which means the goal will not be accepted after that. So now Japan will have a penalty shot.
And she's heading towards the goal. Saskia Ormac trying to dissuade her from putting the ball past. As it comes off the post, and redemption from absolute devastation for the keeper. Just managed to voodoo the ball out of the net, off the post, and it remains Estonia 3, Japan 3.
And that situation is so much pressure for both the goalkeeper and the person shooting the penalty shot.
There's one more shot, one more second. And it's Estonia 3, Japan 3. And a fair result from a fantastic match. And that is enough to give Japan the points to end top of Group D.